So currently there are 94 active cases of coronavirus in Victoria. Overnight we saw 11 new locally acquired cases and no new cases in hotel quarantine. All 11 were linked to known outbreaks. There are 32 cases linked to the Whittlesea outbreak, and that's 3 new cases today. All of those 3 are household contacts of existing cases and have all been in quarantine for their infectious period. There are the three new cases in Arcare Maidstone at that outbreak, bringing that total number to 9, that being 1 resident and 2 new staff members. 2 of these were announced yesterday by Arcare, but included in today's numbers. The next 4 cases are household contacts of cases in the West Melbourne outbreak, bringing the total cases in that particular outbreak to 14. These 4 new cases are 3 children and an adult. There is 1 new case in the Port Melbourne outbreak, bringing the total cases there to 31. That person is a previously identified construction site worker in the city. Our contact tracers are continuing to focus on all of the emerging lines of inquiry with a view to closing them down and following up increasingly on our day 13 testing for our initially identified primary close contacts in the weeks gone past. And the COVID response commander will speak to those figures in more detail. Just touching on vaccines more broadly, yesterday we saw another very strong day, particularly for a Sunday, where we normally see the numbers are in the low thousands. In the state-run clinics, we saw over 17,000 vaccines delivered through right across the state in our clinics. Victorians are really showing that they, given the opportunity, want to get vaccinated as soon as they possibly can as the ticket out of this pandemic. And they're doing so more at the moment than any other state. And we want to make sure that they continue to have that opportunity. And the Commonwealth, we're very pleased, delivers new supplies every week in line with our known forward allocations. Because we are at the moment administering more doses than our allocated usual weekly allocations, the Commonwealth, I'm very pleased, has agreed to provide more, and we welcome that. And I want to thank the Federal Minister and the Federal officials for their cooperation in landing that. Our usual allocation at the moment runs at about 110,000 vaccines a week. And over the last week, for instance, we've used 140,000 doses allocated, the vast majority of those being the first doses. It was pleasing to see that last week, 40% of all Australia's vaccinations were vaccinated here in Victoria. That's down to many things: our fantastic GP partners, the strong desire for Victorians to want to come out and get vaccinated, but it's also down to our open access model of dozens of public vaccination centres right across the state. And it was really heartening to see such a strong turnout of Victorians wanting to get vaccinated. That's why we welcome the federal government's guaranteed second dose supply at National Cabinet on Friday. And work has been underway to look at how we can expand the state's vaccine capacity. And I look forward to having more to say about that in the not too distant future. Again, I want to reiterate, we welcome the federal government's allocations announced yesterday, particularly when it comes to doubling the supply for the next, as I understand it, few weeks for AstraZeneca for our GPs. That is most welcome. We have in fact been eating into our supplies over the course of the past couple of weeks, And having demonstrated that, I was very pleased that the Commonwealth accepted that and provided Victoria with extra doses beyond our allocated standard numbers. The Commonwealth clearly wouldn't be doing that just on spec. We demonstrated that to Commonwealth officials, and they've clearly accepted that we had a strong case for that allocation of extra resources, and I look forward to the continued cooperation and support of the Commonwealth in expanding not just Victoria's but indeed the nation's vaccine program into the future. Today is actually the last day of our extended vaccination blitz for residential disability workers and private and public residential aged care workforces, and we look forward coming Wednesday for our Ambulance Victoria priority walk-up lanes commencing. Before I throw to Minister Donnellan, we do know that this has been a tough period for Victorians, and we do know that there are many challenges if we're all going to stick together to get through this challenging period. These figures give us confidence that all the cases are linked, but we know that as part of the way ahead, there is still much to do. And there's still much to do about making sure that we bring all Victorians along that journey.